Yeah, my name is Vamsidhar. Background wise, I am a BTech computer science engineer plus an MBA from IIM Indore. Almost 11 years of experience, including 3 years in my own business venture, this particular training institute. Prior to that, 8 years I worked in software and education industries. I was in a senior part of a senior management team in a software company as well as an education institute. And in the last 3 years, we are training people for various international finance certification exams like Chartered Financial Analysts, Financial Risk Managers, and all. Apart from that, we do all these workshops. 2 day workshops on skill based, so primarily using Excel as well as SPSS being the core tools which we work on. So the we have programs exclusively on Excel which targets basic and advanced Excel, VBA, dashboards and all, and something more focused towards finance professionals, where all the 2 day workshops targeting financial modeling, both for valuing stocks as well as valuing projects and financial statement analysis, etc. And some courses exclusively designed for risk management professionals. And of course, using SPSS, we are into this this program, which is statistical analysis. And at the same time, we have in-depth market research, econometric analysis, also courses running with using this SPSS itself. Certifications wise, we are heavily into Chartered Financial Analysts and Financial Risk Manager certifications, where a lot of quantitative plus finance, so statistics plus finance, where there is a combo of these two things coming up. So we are trying to expand our course base more from those two perspectives. One is the quantitative techniques and one is the finance as an aspect. So wherever there is an involvement of these two, whatever courses can be handled with these two combinations, so the our portfolio is expanding in that direction. And most of these courses are dealt by me. Right, I don't have a hired trainer. My expertise and my passion is in the areas of quantitative as well as finance. So that's the reason the courses are coming in those directions. And I do a lot of corporate trainings for all these esteemed corporate, ISB, GMR, Dr. Reddy's, ADP, etc. And of course, coming to this training program, this entire class is getting recorded. So I'll give you the recording of this entire class. And of course, because the training is taken by me and I am a part of this, I don't have a hired faculty concept. Probably any point you can come with doubts on your data on which you are doing a research on, you can come back and I can very well address individually also. And whatever the files I am working out, couple of you have got your laptops, couple of you have not. So whatever the data on which I would be working out, all that SPSS files will be shared with you. And I have collected a good number of ebooks on this. So even those would be passed on to you. Now, from your from the backgrounds which I understood and from your expectations of this program, I see that some of you are pretty new to this world of statistics. Right, so here the focus of this 2 day program is, one, to understand statistics, or for what purpose we use the statistics, right? How we differentiate, let's say, a normal business analytics from a statistical analysis, a normal reporting from a statistical analysis, and for what purposes typically I have to use the statistics, and what kind of tools I use to do what kind of outputs. So in a sense, broadly I divide the statistics into two worlds. One is a descriptive statistics world and one is an inferential statistics world. Now, only when these two go together, the real statistical analysis comes into picture. And if I have to put it in two simple words, for what purpose I have to use statistics, one, it is for decision making, or probably a conclusion world, to generalize a conclusion. That's one aspect for which I have to use statistics. Two, to forecast or predict. Two major objectives of using statistics. See, if I have to forecast something, it has to be based on some observations. And that observations, I cannot collect all the observations in the world. Probably I collect some observation, a sample of observations. And using that sample, I have to generalize the forecast. So that's one area where statistics works on. And the second prime area is take a conclusion. Probably recently the exit polls were predicting. In Gujarat, BJP will win probably 120 seats. They did not get access to the voting data or anything. They have done a sample survey. And based on that sample survey, they have done some kind of a conclusion. So, from a sample, generalizing a conclusion is one more aspect where statistics works on. Right? So, if my objective is doing one of these two, either generalize a conclusion or forecast or predict something for the future. If my objective is falling into any one of these two criteria, I depend on statistics. Right? So, from that standpoint, the key part of statistics is the inferential statistics. Because I am making some inference. I am making some conclusion. I am making some generalization from a small sample of observations. So, that's the kind of inference I am doing. But to do that inferencing, I need some calculations to be done. Some of my inferences could be, as I said, BJP will win 120 seats. They never said there is a chance that BJP will win 120 seats. They make it as a general conclusion. BJP will win between 120 to 122 seats, something. Based on whatever the data they have collected. So that's a kind of conclusion they are trying to derive based on some calculation. Or I can very well do some more calculations or conclusions like there is no difference between team A scores and team B scores. Some kind of test has been conducted and let's say I want to say, is there any significant difference between these two people? Right, we collect only some amount of data, and based on that some amount of data, I want to generalize. Or probably sometimes we keep these kind of news saying an average height of an American is 5 centimeters more than a typical average height of an Indian. Now, did they measure the average of all the Indians and did they measure the average height of all the Americans? By the time they measure, there will be some more increase in heights. Right? So, from that standpoint, they only go with some sample. Probably that sample needs to be selected in such a way that it is completely random in nature. It covers all groups across the country, depending on the observations which we require. I am collecting the sample which spans across various states, various types of people, all that stuff. Same with respect to US as well as India. I am taking some average of India. I am taking some average of US. But now, if I had taken a different sample, let's say I have taken this sample and I have got average Indian height is 168 centimeters. And average American height is 173 centimeters. Now, can I say directly that average American height is 5 more than average Indian height? I may not say directly for the simple reason it's only specific to the sample which we have taken. Probably if I had taken a different sample, if I had collected some other set of people, it might so happen that this may go to 170, this may also come down to 169 from 173. So, statistically, there need to be some kind of a measurement purpose, or there should be some kind of a range determination criteria which will still say yes, that 5 is still significant. 5, I can very well say Even if you take some other sample also, the difference definitely exists. I should have that kind of a confidence. So that will come by the observation of the data and by some calculations on the data. Right? So for that purpose, to make some kind of inferences on the data, I definitely need some kind of calculations to be done on that data. And all the calculations which we are doing on the data is what is being described as the world of descriptive statistics. Right? Once I compute, this is like characteristics of the data. Mean, central tendency is a characteristic of the data. Every data we work on, it is characterized by four different major characteristics. One is the central tendency, one is the dispersion, the skewness, and the kurtosis. We'll discuss these things. So these are the four main characteristics of the data. Just like I say, for an individual, probably his name, his age are all characteristics of that person that describe that person. Probably his personality, blah, blah, blah. They describe the person. So these four are the characteristics that describe any set of data. And based on these characteristics, we may have to do some kind of transformations on the data. We may have to do some kind of removing of some of the elements of the data, based on which we'll make our conclusions as well as predictions. Right? So this is a basic start of the statistical world, where in short essence, if I have to talk about in statistics, I will end up doing either some conclusions or some forecasting. The two tasks which I work on. If you say now graphing, and sometimes people say I have to prepare some graphs, I have to prepare some reports. That's not a part of statistics. Probably those are added features. But it is done by any analytics tool. Right? See, computing average, computing mean, median, they are not statistics. They can be done even by, normal averages, sums and all. Even though they fall into the statistical world, but I don't treat them as core stats. The reason being, unless that computation helps me in this, helps me in either generalizing a conclusion or forecasting, it doesn't fall into the critical statistics world. So the calculations are only the basic part of statistics. Any calculation we do, standard deviation, blah, 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 unless I use that to do my prediction, it has no significance. Now, what we will do as a part of this program is take different sets of data. IBM as a tool itself, when you install the software, there are a lot of inbuilt data samples they have given addressing different kinds of scenarios. So we'll take those data samples itself and based on that create a question. Right? This is what is my objective. So which test I have to use? How do I use statistical features? So it's more like question and answer kind of stuff. Now I want to address this. Like I want to test out whether there is any difference between group 1 and group 2. Now if that's the case, what kind of statistical tools we have to use in SPSS? So it goes more like that. Right? Rather than directly saying this is feature 1, feature 2, feature 3. It goes more like a case study kind of a stuff. Right? So with this, I'll start the usage of the SPSS tool. Then we'll move on to doing some kind of statistical tests using that.